Good morning, Glads. I'm Jeremiah Jones.
And I'm Corinne McAfee, and this is your KWHS News.
College and recruiter visits are in full swing in the Counseling Center during lunch and advisory. Remember, you need a pass from the Counseling Center to attend. Here's the lineup.
Colorado College will stop by next week on Tuesday, September 25th. October visits kick off with Colorado Mesa University on Tuesday, October 2nd. Then on Wednesday, October 3rd, the CU Boulder admissions reps will be here. That same day during lunch, the reps from Barbizon Modeling School will be here in the Lower Commons.
On Thursday, October 4th, we will have a very special visit from the U.S. Naval Academy in room 501 at lunch. If you have questions about what college is like at a service academy, this would be a great visit to attend. On October 11th, the reps from CSU Pueblo are scheduled to visit, and the last visit we have for you in October for now is with the reps from Ozark Christian College, who are scheduled to visit on October 16th.
Luther College just scheduled a visit for Wednesday, November 7th, and Fort Hays State University in Kansas scheduled their visit on Tuesday, November 13th. On November 15th, UCCS has a visit scheduled. After Thanksgiving, on November 29th, there will be a visit from Adams State. We'll keep you posted on any changes to the schedule, so pencil them in on your calendar.
Before we move on, the Counseling Center would also like to remind juniors and seniors that WHS will be an ACT test site on Saturday, October 27th. The deadline to register for this exam date is September 28th. If this date doesn't work for you, check out other testing dates and locations at this website. If you are taking the ACT without the writing portion, the fee will be $50.50. If you want to take the ACT plus writing, expect to pay $67 for that test. Check with the counseling office or go online at this website for registration and other information.
Attention juniors, if you're interested in taking the PSAT NMS QT test, a qualifier for the National Merit Scholarship, WHS will be giving that on Wednesday, October 10th. The cost is $16, and space is limited to the first 20 people who sign up. The deadline to sign up is October 5th by the end of the day.
Also seniors, WHS will be hosting a financial aid night on Monday, October 1st at 5 p.m. in the library. Come meet with financial aid specialists who will help you learn how financial aid works, how to apply for student loans, and most importantly, how to fill out the FAFSA. If you have them available, bring in your tax information so you can get started on filling out that very important form. Mr. Walker in the Counseling Center is your contact for this event, so give him a call or email him with any questions.
And one last note for seniors. The first senior class meeting will be on September 27th during an advisory in the auditorium. Be sure to attend this meeting to get some very important information about your final year here. If you cannot make it, check in with Ms. Abeda in the Counseling Center for more details.
The City of Lights Homecoming Dance is coming up on Saturday, September 29th from 7 to 11 p.m. in Bowers Gym. Today is the final day to get your tickets for $10. On Monday, tickets jump to $15 per person. If you wait until the dance, tickets at the door will cost you $20.
Guest forms for homecoming are available in the main office. The deadline to turn those in is today. Ladies, Becca's Closet has some new inventory. Make an appointment with Ms. Ford in room 122 to shop for your dress. And remember, the dresses are free and yours to keep.
Coming up, we'll have Miss Betsy and her guest with today's lunch menu, so stay tuned. But first, let's head to the sports desk with Kieran Doolittle for scores and upcoming events. What's going on, Kieran?
Good Friday morning, Gladiators. I'm Kieran Doolittle, and this is your Gladiator Sports Update. Our new athletic trainer this year, Patrick Damon, is bringing back the weekly health tip. So here's Damon's Daily Dose.
You're on with Damon's Daily Dose of Health. My health tip for you guys this week, if you find yourself tired during 5th and 6th hour, you might need to evaluate the meals you're eating during lunch. If you're having high sugars, you might be going through an energy spike and a drop. Try something like cutting out those simple sugars and adding something like fruit. That's our tip of the day. Take care.
That's great advice. In tennis news, the boys are on the road today and tomorrow for a tournament at Fountain Fort Carson. The team has been in a bit of a slump. We hope they find their rhythm and swing with gusto this weekend. We'll have scores for you on Monday. Our boys' golf team has the fewest spectators to attend their matches, but they still go out there and play the game like the gentlemen they are. We are very happy to report that our very own Joey Stroop has made it to the 4A State Golf Tournament for the second consecutive year. This unsung hero on the links will play in the state tournament at the Flying Horse Golf Course on October 1st and 2nd. In volleyball news, the ladies matched up against the Falcons last night, and despite some strong setting and promising spikes, the ladies did not get their dub. You can catch the ladies again on our home court next Thursday when they take on Elizabeth Cardinals at 6 p.m. Our Lady Glad softball team has been en fuego over their last few games, spanking their opponents with some hefty scores. This weekend, the ladies take their gladiator power and those hot bats to the Doherty tournament. Keep on swinging, ladies. We'll have scores for you on Monday. Our boys' soccer team has also been on fire with some crazy finishes, and last night was no exception. The boys took on the Elizabeth Cardinals last night and punched in a great win.
Whoosh.
Next week, the boys will be on the road for a match against Canyon City on Tuesday at 6:30 p.m. In cross-country news, Mother Nature wasn't the only one who brought the heat yesterday afternoon. Our cross-country team clocked in some fast times at the Coronado Invite as they make their trek to regionals. Well done, runners.
Whoosh.
Speaking of heat, this afternoon our drumline battery will march through the halls starting at 2:30 to get us all pumped for the game. After school, they will be circling up for a snare freestyle outside the band room. Catch the band tomorrow at the community parade and later at the big game. They will have new uniforms and, weather permitting, may break them out for us this weekend. Since this is Spirit Week, the Football Booster Club is selling shirts for $5 at lunch today. There are a limited number of shirts, so you should get yours for the big game this weekend. And Glads, it's officially here, the big rivalry game. The WSD3 showdown between our WHS Gladiators and that other district school. Our Glads are hangry for their first win, and it would be so sweet to get it against the Purple School.
G-G-G-O-A!
Be sure to be in the stands at 1 p.m. for the WSD3 showdown. We are the home team this year.
Go Glads! Beat Mesa!
And finally, to get everyone else just as pumped as the football team is, Student Cabinet is hosting a car bash today at lunch outside the science wing by the counseling center. For $1, you get 30 seconds to take your best shots at the car. You know you want to. Come check it out.
Go Glads! Beat Mesa!
Go Glads! Beat Mesa!
That's your Gladiator Sports Update. I'm Kieran Doolittle. See you at the game. Now back to you, Jeremiah and Corinne.
Go Glads! Beat Mesa!
Are you hungry yet? Here's Miss Betsy and her guests with today's lunch menu.
Oh, happy Friday! Hey, so excited! Friday. Hey, listen, what are we in for lunch today?
I heard something about beefy soft tacos.
Beefy soft tacos. With all the good stuff, onions, tomatoes, and lettuce.
Wait. They're gonna be beans?
There's gonna be beans.
Bet that was gonna be fun.
Oh, I bet it will be. Hey, that's great. On Monday, we are going to have
pork roast with smashed potatoes.
Mashed potatoes and
mashed
gravy.
Potatoes.
Loving it, right? Mm-hmm. Y'all have a great one, and please don't forget to bring in your yellow papers.
See
Bye.
You at the festival this weekend.
Yipper.
Thanks, Miss Betsy. Students, remember the deadline to return your free and reduced lunch applications is September 27th. After that date, Miss Betsy cannot extend any credit for your lunches. If you owe money on your lunch account, you can pay those charges in the cafeteria or add money to your account online.
If you did not have your picture taken or you need to retake your photos, picture retake day is today. This is for students and teachers. If you are retaking your photos, you must return the picture order you received.
The school store is closed today, but you can pick up your gladiator gear at the booth tomorrow at the WSD 3 showdown to get ready for Spirit Week.
Go Glads! Beat Mesa!
Speaking of Spirit Week, Glads, get your outfits ready for Monday and show your spirit. Spirit Week is a chance to earn more points for your class, so get those outfits ready for 7th hour counts. Here's the dress up day schedule. Monday, September 24th, Preppy Day. Dress like your favorite college student. Hats will be allowed. Tuesday, September 25th, Meme Day. Make yourself into a real-life meme. Wednesday, September 26th, Tie-Dye Day. Be groovy in your tie-dye. Thursday, September 27th, Colorado Day. Sport your awesome Colorado gear for this great state. Friday, September 28th, Class Color Day. Wear your class color. Remember, every day you dress up is a day your class can earn points.
Students, Renaissance applications are now available on the WHS website under Activities. You'll need to download and print your applications to apply for this honor. Only seniors, juniors, and sophomores are eligible this time. Applications are due on October 1st by 3 p.m. to Ms. Price in the main office.
Seniors, listen up. Your senior photo and quotes are due by October 19th. See Mrs. Kennedy in room 103 for additional details on how to submit those for the yearbook. That's it for our Friday edition, Glads. I'm Jeremiah Jones. See you at the parade.
And I'm Corinne McAfee, and this is your KWHS News. Have a great weekend.
Go Glads! Be Mesa!